गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, आई होप यू आर फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल एंड योर वीकली टेस्ट वॉज वेरी गुड आई थिंक सो. एंड नाउ कम टू द अगेन इन द सेम टॉपिक टॉपिक नॉट सेम चैप्टर दैट इज आवर कम्युनिटी लाइफ यूनिटी इन डाइवर्सिटी चैप्टर नंबर 21 इन सिविक्स. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस रिकैपिटुलेट ऑफ things of the topics which already we discussed. So I welcome you all in today's online class. Now come. So in the first day we discussed what is the meaning of civics, literal meaning and also meaning. Next we also discussed that is read about the name father of civics, Benjamin Franklin, then Constitution of India, and also that is the father of Indian Constitution, Bhimrao Ramji Ambedkar. And next, that is the preamble. It is one the introductory information, just like the introduction. Next, that is importance of studying civics. Why we have to study the civics? Why we need to study the civics? This thing also we read. Next, that is I have asked one question: can you live alone? It is impossible because we are living in a society. We need support. We are social animal. We need support of different type of people. It may be that is doctor, it may be nurse, it may be that is vegetable vendor, it may be tailor, it may be teacher. We need support. Without support, we cannot fulfill our needs. Next, that is who are called a social animal, those who are living in a society, those who are living in a group, those who are supporting each other, those who are interdependent on each other, that is called a social animal. It is not only human beings, but also ants, birds, insects, mammals, so many animals are there. Human beings are also social animal. Why human beings are social animal? Because we cannot live alone. We need support. We need the help of others because we cannot fulfill our each and every demand by our own activities. That's why we live in a society. So now come to the today's topic. So what is the today's topic? First topic, that is society. I have already told, and in the last class also we completed the last topic, that is we are social animal, we are living in a society. So when that word is coming, that is society, that means we are social animal. That's why we are living in a society. So what is society? First of all, society means it is one type of group of people, group of individuals, group of persons. Now the question, why are they making group? Because we need support, we need help, and we are interdependent on each other. You will help someone and someone also will help you. That is called as interdependence. Interdependence on his thing. Maybe it is religious interdependence, maybe political interdependence, maybe cultural interdependence, so many types of. So that's why we are living in society. So what is society? It is one group where that is people are the members, individuals are the members. And why are they making that type of group? To fulfill the demand, to fulfill the need, to get the support. That is called a society. So we are living in which society? Indian society. We are living in India. So India has a society, and that is called as Indian society. So now another thing, that is whenever we are talking about society, it is it has so many, that is small communities. Society is means what? It is the combination of communities. So what is community? Community means it is also a group of people. When you are living in a society, you are also living in a community. But society, it is Indian society, but your community is not Indian, it is different. So when you are talking about your community, that you are from Hindu community, your friend is from Christian community, your another friend is from Muslim community. So community is the part of society. Here also the group of people, here it is also a group of people, but it is slightly different from the society. So what is the difference between society and community? We will discuss point wise and also topic wise. So community means it is a group of people, it is a group of persons. And here one thing, that is what, here that type of people are coming in this group, those who have some common feelings, those who have some similarities. When I am talking about that you are from Hindu community, that means what? Who are the members of this group? Only the people, those who belong to the Hindu religion. That means what? Similarity present. But when we are talking about Indian society, that means what? In this society, Hindu present, Muslim present, Christian present, and also different type of people of different culture present. That means what? There are variations present. Similarity present, variation also present in society. But in community, the people, those who are coming from same interest, those who have some similarities, they are making the group that is called as community. Clear? So now let us find out the differences. So society is a group. Community is also a group. That is only the similarity. But society is the bigger one and the community, it is smaller than the society. And society means differences present, similarities present, and community means only mainly similarities present. That means I have already given you the example, Hindu community, so Hindu religion people are there, Muslim community, Muslim people are there. But when we are talking about Indian society, Hindu present, Muslim present, Christian, that means what? Similarity, differences present, but mainly differences in the society and in community, that is similarities are there. That means what? Community is the part of society. So many communities, Hindu community plus Muslim community plus Christian community plus etc. etc. That means it is making the Indian society. So society is the combination of community. So many communities combined together and which is formed, that is society. Clear? So we are, so always remember, we are living in a society, also we are living in a community. Now come to the next. Essential elements of community. So when we are living in a community, some essential things, important things require. First thing, we feeling. We feeling means what? That there is no selfish nature. I and we, there is difference present. I means you are thinking about yourself. Yourself is now. And we feeling means what? You are thinking about not yourself, about the others also. That is we feeling. That is the basic thing of community. When you are living in the community, you have to think about other. That is because you are in a group. Second thing, likeness or similarities. When you are you want to join a community, you have to find out what is the similarity present. You want to join Hindu community, so you have to be similar. Similar means you must have Hindu religion. So that is similarity, likeness. It is a group of people. Yes, that is also right. It is a group of people. Next, a community is permanent. That means when you entered in the Hindu community, that means what? You have Hindu religion. That's why. So that means you are the permanent member. Every community has some particular name that I have already told, the Hindu community, Sikh community. That means what? Each and every community has a particular name. So that means I have already told we are living in a society, that's why we are social animal, we are living in a community, that's why we have a life that is called as community life. So what is called as community life? Community life means it is the life where we live together, that and also why we are living together. We are living to fulfill our needs, we are living to fulfill our requirements and also to help each other. That is, so we are living in a community. Why? To live together, to help each other, for interdependence, for requirements. And in this community life, who are coming? Your family is also coming, your school is also coming, your neighbor also coming. These are the part of our community life. So these are the part of our community life. Who are they? Family, it is the beginning. Then a school, your neighbor, they are also required in your community life. The three things we have to read in this chapter: family, school and neighbor. Now come to the next. Why do we need a community life? Already I told, but separately we have to write down in copy, because I have already told we cannot live alone. We cannot say that no, I can fulfill my own demands by my own deeds. It is not possible. We need the support of so many people. It may be teacher. That means we are interdependent. We have to take the support from different professions. That's why we have to live in a community life. Next, that is how to develop our community life, because we are living in this life. So we have to think how to make it better. So how can you make it better? First thing, basically there are three things we have to maintain: togetherness, that means there is no selfish thinking, there is no selfish nature, there is no feeling of I, always the feeling of we. Next, that is interdependence, that means you have taken help, you have to help this person whenever it is required. Interdependence and social well-being, that means you have to support other, you have to do some good activities in the society, you have to do some good activities for the other, that is called as social well-being. So that's all for today. So today we have discussed about which thing, what is society, and also that is what is community, what are the differences between society and community, and also that what is community life, why do we need to live in a community life, how can you improve the community life, how can you develop the community life, what are the things or elements in a community life. And that is, I have already told, your school is coming under community life, your family is coming under community life, your neighbor is coming under community life. So these are the things we have to remember. These are related to today's topic. Next we will discuss about the other things related to community life. That's all for today. If you have any query, if you have done any doubt, feel free to contact and put up the query, and I will try to solve your problem. Thank you and have a great day.